Please be advised.
Adventures in Initiative may have triggering content for some viewers.
Adventures and Initiative presents VALMIRAH.
Hello and welcome to Adventures in Initiative. I am your DM, Dono. Let's get a little review of what happened last time. Players, for inspiration. Okay, Shop, go for it.
They transition so they can see our pretty faces. Yeah. Hi. And I'm just going to use the Instagram post that I wrote because that's the best summary of last time I've ever made. If it loads, there's one more. Alrighty, so previously on VALMIRAH. The party left the manor of Professor Kor, short one dwarven bard, and started planning the pursuit of the douchebag Grum. Also known as, I don't even remember his name, but it's in our game notes. They met a new ally along the way in the Warforged Barbarian Guard 7. Almost got eaten by griffins, but those were scared off by a weird, as I believe Drunk wrote it, crazy lady in the woods. Named Ilus, something like that. Finally, after traveling around the edge of Lake Laxos, made their way back to the town of Pais, which they got there and discovered it being attacked by winged kobolds, which is where we ended.
Also, Guard 7, I believe, cast teleportation on a crab with his fist.
Yes, I cast teleport by fist.
Tubbsy says hello to the guest.
Hello.
Yes, we
have we do have our guest. We will introduce him. Well, actually,
yeah, do things right now.
You guys have probably about, I'd say, 3 rounds till you actually would get close enough to the warehouse.
Well, we can introduce character in game, but let's intro the guest at least.
Let's intro the guest, shall we?
All right.
Pete, would you please give your introduction, character description, etc.
Now, hi guys, I am Pete. Or you may know me as BananaSkins on TikTok. I am playing a tiefling warlock called Peregrine, or known as Wicked Babylon.
I will put the character arc up since I have that.
Yeah.
Which, that was fun to resize for Instagram.
Sorry, I did.
Oh no, you're good.
I sent you like a sized down version of what I had originally.
No, it was because like, Instagram has the original's like really weird megabyte portrait ratios because they don't go they don't go standard. They have 1080 by 1350.
Yeah,
which is just so weird. But here,
okay. Luckily I have something on my phone that allows me to actually try and change like image proportions so I can make it so it isn't squashed out.
The gorgeous image, which our watchers can now see. Of Banana's character. And now you shall never see it again.
I assure you, he's nice. He's nice. He just looks a bit menacing.
He's nice. I swear he's nice.
Alrighty.
Alright.
And I'm going to mute myself so people don't hear me chewing.
Alright, so as you guys run towards the warehouse, seeing that there are flames, kobolds flying around above, and people running about trying to take out the flames themselves. Please make perception checks for me. From the two players.
You can also roll for Briar.
That's a 9? Oh yeah, roll for Briar too.
And come on. 16.
16, okay.
It's a good sign. It's a good Briar. Day.
And 14 for Briar.
Okay. 16, 14, good enough. You can tell that the winged kobolds are carrying buckets around while they're also flying. And they seem to be circling back from the warehouse to the lake in the motion and such. Do with that information as you please.
The town is on fire, right?
Like no, just one warehouse.
One warehouse.
On the dock. So you wouldn't know it.
Would like, this look like a bucket like chain?
Make an intelligence check for me.
Yeah, that plus one. Eight.
I see what you did there.
Eight. It looks like it's got a bucket. It's a weapon.
I mean, you know a bucket's not a weapon, but...
It could be. Anything's a weapon.
Anything's a weapon if you hit something hard enough with it.
Think of a bucket, like, just passively think of a bucket.
If you're a monk, everything's a weapon.
I know, right? Or a tavern brawler.
That leg, four, the fork, beer keg.
You can also hear screaming of people trying to get a hold, trying to figure out ways to get water to the, I can't speak, get to the warehouse in order to take out the flames. The flames do not seem to be very high at this point in time. It seems like it's centered onto one side of it, but you can definitely see blackened smoke coming from it. That is slowly turning white.
Bells.
So it seems like it may have just started.
Well, we should go see if we can help them, guys. Come on, come on, come on.
And now you can also see what seems to be a very interestingly dressed gentleman with a wide-brimmed hat, a kind of brown cloak, also directing some of the people around, and seems to have taken charge in the situation. And we see Pete's character now as he's trying to direct people and knowing what to do. So... if you wish, you guys can roll initiative, or however you would like to solve this situation. Would you like to do it skills? Would you like to do it as a combat kind of form? Or what? You guys can also see what seems to be crates. You can make searches around, try and find things, figure out things that you have on yourself, spells that you may have. I want you guys to get creative in this situation. Yeah. So,
how close is the building to the water itself?
So let me actually, that's a good question.
Yeah, because my biggest thing is guard is looking to see if there's anybody actively in danger.
I'm decently sure it's about 40, 50 feet from the water, but it's honestly like, so the way that the warehouse and the dock is built is that the dock is built slightly over the water and then there's more dock.
Yeah, it's like a waterway with just warehouses built to receive cargo. Mm-hmm.
Yes,
so
exactly.
It's like right over the water.
Yes, so it's over the water. So
if I were to say direct an Eldritch Blast at a downward angle, could I splash the water up onto the flames on the building?
That will depend upon what you roll for an attack. What the power of the Eldritch Blast is. And then I'll throw a little, so I'll make up a DC in my head, and if you can hit it with your, with like a dex, and then as such, yeah, you can probably do that.
That's a 23.
Okay, yeah, that definitely happens. You're able to, through like slots within the water, or slots within the dock itself, able to shoot blasts. Like it's not even like angles or shot like a beam, it's just literally your boom, like you're shooting, force energy underneath, and you're able to see where the water is, and it's shooting up and shooting these big old splashes into the water or onto the warehouse in order to kill some of the flames. And that is success. That is one success for you guys. Yeah. In a creative motion. Congratulations.
How far away am I from the warehouse itself?
I will say that you are safe enough distance that you're not like getting taken by flames, but you're also close enough to determine different things. I will say that you have five gentlemen within your use that you are directing. Three of them have buckets. Few of them may have like some axes in order to cut things away, whatever you may need. Just helping hands in which you can direct. And
so like I say to the guys that are holding the axes, all right, you two head in there and see if you can find any way in that's not covered in flames, obviously, and you can find anyone that's been trapped within there. I do not want anyone getting stuck in there, all right?
All right. Make a quick persuasion check with advantage, since they're already listening to you.
And Dono, running straight to a flame, is actively looking for anybody in danger, so if he can hear this, he's gonna hop in.
Okay, yes.
That's a 12?
Let me see here. Half of them will listen, the other half will kind of be like, I don't, like, some of them get the encouragement to go do it, other ones don't. Guard 7 will join in with it, so guard...
I grab the guy that doesn't want to do it.
Okay.
By the scruff of his shirt, mm-hmm. and pull him in close.
Deal with the blue watery dice.
Listen here, mate. I'm not staying for you to go in there and get stuck in there yourself, alright? You go in there and help anyone that's in there, alright? You are needed here. You did not sign up for this to go and pussy out at the last minute. Go in there.
Make an intimidation roll, and guard, you can roll with advantage since you have other people with you.
Okay.
So roll again for me.
Cool.
Sorry.
We're going to try the C dice this time.
19.
Okay, that is successful as you not hear just like,
that's a dirty 20.
Very nice. You do see, so what you see within the warehouse itself, it is not completely full of smoke yet. You call out to see if you can find or if anybody will respond. You hear the sound of what is a coughing voice off to the side. It seems farther away from the smoke, but it's within like a crate area. Inside of this warehouse, there seems to be these different pools of water that are here, and they seem to be full of fish, crabs, things. It seems to be like cleaning stations. There are belts.
Oh, this is a fishery warehouse.
Yes.
Okay.
It's also storage and such like that. So from all the crates and everything, they use it as boats and things. So yeah.
Once he sees that there's people, how close is the fire to one of these like washing or holding tanks for fish?
I'd say about 20 feet.
And how big are they? Are they like 3 foot tall?
So
or like
I'd say
6 foot?
That they're about 5 to 7 feet.
Okay, so they're like big barrels.
Yeah, they're like big, large barrels. They go deep and they're into water, but they go straight into.
Oh, they go straight down into the actual lake.
Yeah, and then
like,
they have like this kind of like, I want to say cage situation. So like
at the bottom.
Damn.
I was hoping I could like pick one up and chuck it at the fire.
Sorry. I mean, you could tear it out of the dock.
That's what I was gonna do, but it's like if it's going down into the water, the water's not gonna come with it.
For that to happen, I mean, you can certainly try.
Nah, he's just gonna try and move back in the warehouse, and just call out, "In the name of Nela, come to me. I will help you."
Okay, make a persuasion check for me.
Which, of course, nobody's gonna know who the hell Nela is in this part of the world. Okay, that cocked. It literally bounced out, rolled, and then ended up sideways next to another dice.
The finale of every basketball movie ever.
Cock. The cocked one was almost better than that. Persuasion, right?
Yeah.
Three.
You hear a voice say, "I'm too scared, mate. This whole place seems like it's gonna fall down at some point. If I go any closer, I could. I don't know. I'm just scared."
How far is this guy from the door, and what race is he?
You can't really tell what his race is.
I would be moving towards him. I'm trying to get eyes on him.
Make dexterity checks as you go to walk, because some of the framing is...
Oh, finally! Something that...
So
nope,
just making sure that you don't snap something, and you don't have things fall on you.
That's better. That's 17.
17. Okay. You successfully are able to maneuver around this base of this warehouse, able to stay away from weakened parts. You like hear one piece that just snaps, mm-hmm. but you have like enough weight on one foot that you're able to bounce away and then come around it.
Am I doing the hot feet, hot sand dance across this?
It's more of like you're being very careful in crawling about, kind of like you're at a standing crawl and you're kind of using things to distribute your weight because you don't know what is, because of the fire, you don't know what is not good. Like, not stable. Sorry, not good is not a very good, but stable. Yeah. It's not stable.
Okay.
So.
But once I have eyes on him, just what race is he and how far is he from the door?
He seems to be Genasi.
I was hoping for small.
No. He seems to be about 6 feet in size. You could carry him easily.
Is there a wall near him?
Yes. Yes, there is a wall near him.
An exterior wall?
Yeah. Are you going to break through the wall?
Let me check something. Okay, this is a plus zero, so we'll see. I would like to intimidate him of either you come with me outdoor or I make new door there. Which you want?
An intimidation roll?
And just for the wonderful emphasis, he's a 6 foot top five, what appears to be person in full plate mail with a giant fucking sword on his back. I am a full on anime character. Just fucking guts walking in.
Right, Alpha,
bitch, get out the door. That's a 16.
16. He just kind of like opens up his arm and is like, whatever you want.
Pick him up under my arm. Literally, I'm just going to like potato sack him.
He just kind of like has these little bits of weeping eyes.
Yeah, I'm just going to potato sack him and walk him out. Right. Trying to use the same spots that I had already walked on.
All right. With that, make straight dexterity. Not with advantage, because the carrying would disadvantage with since you're using the same stepping. Yeah.
I figure carrying him I have no problem since I have a plus four. It's just the don't step on a floorboard that's going to put us in the water.
Yep.
Plus my dex is a 15.
15. That's good enough. You're successfully able to take this person out of the warehouse and bring them back. You see the other gentlemen that have been doing other things and trying to take some buckets that are inside from the water inside, throwing it over what seems to be the flames that are inside the warehouse, trying to cool those down. I'm going to roll for them really quick. That's a success. And after about 10, 20 minutes of you guys going back and forth and working this out, the damage is very minimum. There is a large hole on the side that has been burned through in the warehouse, but you are successful in stopping the fire.
I just want to point out that Merish, as he was using the Eldritch Blast into the water, he was giggling every time it shot up into the air.
The kid just figured out he can make water spouts in the pool.
Yeah. But congratulations, you guys. You did a great job. I'm so proud of you. All right.
I'll switch us back to less combat music.
So now it's kind of whatever you guys would like to do.
Guard 7's gonna go over to the guy he's scared and apologize to him. Just be like, I am sorry, but in the moment you were panicking, and I needed you to make quick decision. I hope you do not feel bad.
He's just kind of curled up in a ball with like a cup of
pet,
drinking. He's just like,
Hey, guard, did you see how high that water went?
It was very good. You helped very well, Merish. Pet.
You see a short-looking tiefling come running up to you. I saw it. I saw that. That was pretty cool.
Yeah, it was cool. You're kind of weird looking.
You want to see one go even higher?
Maybe
you
not right
do
now.
That?
We do not know stability of building. But you are very good at organizing people.
Guards just ignoring you guys about to cast Eldritch Blast. His eyes are like soft blue, trying to soothe the guy crying on the ground.
I'm going to charge a Eldritch Blast myself and aim it at the water to try and aim it to splash up on the building again.
Roll for it.
Alright. That is a 23.
23. That's, you get about the same amount as what Merish gave.
I thought you said it was going to go higher.
Also, Toby just pointed this out in the chat, and I'm so happy. I just pulled K2SO at the beginning of Rogue One. You are being rescued. Please do not resist. Hi, I'm the robot of the party.
I've had a rough day, all right? I've been directing these idiots around. They're not been listening to me. They see one lick of fire and they're wetting themselves.
And you see
fire what? Can well, be quite terrifying. God,
this is weird.
Oh. How fire start?
You see one of the gentlemen that's just kind of overhearing your conversation come over and just be like, well, honestly, it seems there was just like a short burst of something and flames started picking up and everybody just kind of rolled out. Now we started having a panic and everything, and you also see one of the winged kobolds come over and be like, all right, boss, we got it. We dumped all the bucket water on you. We did our best.
Is that what you were doing? I thought you were wielding weapons.
No!
I almost threw a javelin.
And he pulls out like little... Well, he pulls out like a dagger, but like this is a filleting knife.
Or anything's a weapon if you hit it hard enough.
Especially a bucket dropped from high above can be very good for ballistics.
But I'm good at not carrying bucket and pouring water.
Good work. And he just like raises his hand up for like, this is called Nela 5. You hit.
He punches it.
Very good. Puts his hand.
Hey, that looks nice.
And then the older gentleman, he seems to be kind of black salt and pepper hair, full beard, little older in age, not quite sure. Sun-touched skin, a little bit of rosiness on the cheeks, maybe been out for a little bit too long. There's like a little bit of smoke on the side of his face. He wears not normal common clothing. But he seems like a little more well done up than everybody else. And he's just like, well, fuck, what was his voice again? If I'm being honest, it seemed like maybe not one of the power crystals that we had might have short-circuited and blown. Well, I don't really see, but within the area in which it was located, it was there. It was where the power is, so we probably just had a little bit of an electrical problem.
Well, you should probably get that looked at.
Yeah, we're going to end up having to get some things replaced, and we'll do some manual things, and we'll get the hole covered up.
Yes, I have it's experience gonna cost us with a bit. Electrical problem. They can be very annoying.
You got a stutter there, mate.
Is that normal?
He just opens his visor. I do not have voice box for stutter. I just have malfunction.
Oh, shit.
And closes it.
You're not a person. Yeah, you just see the dude, like, eyes go wide. And he's just like, oh, I thought you were a dude in there.
No, I am Guard 7, servant of the goddess Nela. I am glad we could be of assistance.
That's some impressive technology there.
He's just like opens his eyes a little bit more.
The guy on the ground starts crying even harder.
He's like, I want to go home. I want to go home.
He was just rescued by the Iron Giant.
Hey, there's some wood in there. So for Pete's sake, couldn't resist. Guard 7 is 6 foot tall, broad shoulders. He has a large, it looks like, if you've ever seen the Japanese cleavers that have the front, instead of being flat, is actually like a curve. He has a large greatsword like that, but you can see that it's been sharpened so much, the edge is actually starting to curve in on itself across his back, and a copper circlet around his head, and all of his plates are this like dark steel and iron. And then he wears a doublet and pants. For some reason, this guy made of metal is just wearing clothes. Like, everybody sees him as, oh, you're in armor, but you have clothes over the armor.
Why did the Warforge leave her boyfriend?
I don't know.
Because he didn't have any ball bearings.
Oh, that's good. That's good.
The dad energy in this chat right now. Because two-fourths, half of this chat has kids. I mean, I'm assuming you're like 19, so I hope you don't have kids yet.
Nah, yeah, so
Dono.
Yes.
Would this person, this fishmonger, be willing to procure me the largest fish I could possibly buy?
Are you talking to the boss guy that has?
Yeah, I mean, I like the destruction of the
building with a fish.
I'm sure when the ships come in, we'll pick out the biggest one that we got, and I'll bring it to you. Where are you staying?
Where are we staying?
Do we have?
Hey, Briar, where are we staying?
I think probably the Tapped Keg here in town. That's where we stayed last time.
That's where you've been staying.
I thought we stayed at the brothel.
No, that's where Yip lives.
Oh, wait.
We stayed there one night because the Tap Keg got shut down after, you know,
oh, that's right. I wonder if he'll let me cook again.
That's right. The investigation was going on.
Yeah, the whole thing that, like, is the reason we came, well, you guys came back to town. Fucking Guard 7 can go wherever he wants. He just got lost in the woods and that crab wouldn't give him directions, so teleport by fist.
This is some context I really, really want to hear.
Well, everything is recorded on a podcast, so...
Yes, I will.
There are 8 episodes to catch up on. It's about 16 hours.
I will take a look at that.
It's a good time. Yeah, we're staying at the Tap Keg. Here's some gold.
He looks at you kind of like curious and be like, all right. I'm guessing they're good now. You hand him some gold. He like refuses and like, we'll just bring it to you. Don't worry.
Yes, that's why he's here.
Briar takes a second and thinks about it and he's like, I've got somebody that I need to kind of check in with. And like, I'll meet up with you guys at the tavern. And
all right, Briar, see you in a little bit.
All right.
Scales are that nice red, excited color.
Is Yip still like hanging around, or has Yip kind of like slipped off to go visit home?
Yip has kind of Yip takes a second, goes yip, and kind of like does this, like heading.
Guard 7 just kind of like, bye-bye.
And
what the fuck is human emotions?
Takes off as well to. Yip, by the way, is this little tiny cat person.
By tiny, we mean like 3 feet tall when standing on her hind legs.
Like the cat creatures from like Monster Hunter.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
He has a miscolored eye and has like a scar above his head and does not speak English. Like,
and a staff. Words,
like, he can say certain words, but yeah. That's how he's been created, so.
Yeah, and a staff with, like, bones and little... All the, like, weird things cats would bring in that can be used as spell components, hanging on a staff.
Oh, I see, yeah. That's cool. I like that.
Yeah. I refuse to give you... It's okay, Pi. I'm sure it's having a great time wherever he transported him, so.
Well, part of it's over there, part of it's over there, part of it's over there.
Refused to give you directions.
That's how we introduced Guard 7, is he got lost in the woods and was asking a crab that was hanging on his hand directions, and then got annoyed at it, and boop, and I rolled like a 20.
So, you guys begin to enter into town.
Is the tiefling following us?
Are you? What are you guys wanting to do? Because I will not say if you guys enter into town. It's up to you what you wish to do.
Guard was just like complimenting the tiefling. Just, you did very good directing people. What is your name?
Oh, thank you. My name is Babylon. First name Peregrine, but most people just call me Babylon.
You're kind of creepy looking.
Merish, we talked about being polite. After you insulted that weird lady in the woods.
She was weird.
I did not argue that. I just said you shouldn't say it to her face. This is Merish. I am Guard 7. That was Yip and Briar.
Nice to meet you. And by the way, yes, I can be a little bit creepy at times. It's the eyes. I know it throws people off.
You got a pretty cool tail, though. Mine's not as cool as yours.
Thank you. You say you wanted to stay somewhere. I've got a caravan, parked nearby that you can use for a bit.
Well, I was gonna go to the Tap Keg. I was gonna see if the cook would let me use his kitchen again. I like to cook.
The cook left town. He hated you.
He did.
This like fully trained bugbear cook who got shown up by what, a 14-year-old lizard folk?
Yep.
Who's never had training.
God damn it.
Son of a bitch.
She's mad.
If you can do it better than do it.
So are you guys heading to the Tap Cave then?
Yeah. Guard would invite Babel and just, if you like, you come. Have drink, we will watch.
Okay. Well, I can have a drink too.
You can drink water.
Well, they gave me chocolate milk last time.
What is chocolate milk?
Oh, it's delicious.
It's part of the cocoa bean.
He just leans in. Tell me more of this cocoa bean.
You just hear that from like someone randomly.
The entire campaign changes, and now we have to find cocoa beans.
All right, you guys are no longer going to crawl. You're going to the freaking
screw the
swamp.
Douchebag Grung that almost killed one of the characters and instead turned him into a rage zombie.
Yeah, that was fun. So as you guys begin to make your walk towards the Tapped Cake, please make perception checks.
Ooh.
That is a 22 for Merish and
14 for Guard.
Okay. 13 for Briar.
14 right. For Babylon.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Oh, Briar's not with us.
Yeah, Briar's not with you.
Sorry.
You're good. So don't worry about rolling for her for a little bit. As you guys begin to walk down the road or walk down the streets of the city, you begin to notice there's a few more guards around than usual. Hmm. And you seem to be being followed. And then you get... And then you see a larger gentleman, human, completely covered within that plate armor in front of you, in the front of you in the road, as a couple of guards begin to flank you. This says,
oh, we've been waiting for you.
Why?
Really? Why have you been waiting for me?
I take it you didn't invite
him. I don't know who you are, but I've been looking for this guy.
Why?
He points to Merish. You were told not to leave the city, and you left.
Is a friend of yours?
She got us permission.
Get him in handcuffs, boys, as some of the guards begin to take your arms.
Guard has his sword out and is standing in front of Merish.
I wouldn't do that if I were you, boy.
You are attempting to arrest a child without a parent present. If
you
wish
to
talk...
Would you like
to come with him?
Huh? Would you like to come with him?
I will come with, but you will not arrest child. This is not guardly behavior. There are other members of his party who are of age and can speak for him. They have gone to speak with someone. I will not allow you to interrogate him without them.
Do you know where his other party members went? We would be very interested in meeting with them.
Did Briar actually say where she was going, or just say she had a meeting?
She had. Nope. She said she had a meeting. She'll be back.
Yep. They are in city somewhere. I do not know where. If you need to have conversation with Merish, why do you not make it peaceful? Sit down in Tapped Keg, have drink and talk.
I understand where you're coming from, friend. I'm not a drinker of sorts. I refuse from the liquor.
I was not talking of liquor. I have been told
we can get you some chocolate milk.
He's literally like, now he just thinks chocolate milk is like something really important.
I'm also, unfortunately...
It comes from the cocoa.
It's like the one person who can fucking solve this.
Sir, we had permission. Go ask the mayor. I saw the letter myself. And I'd like to try and persuade him to go talk to the mayor.
Okay, make a persuasion check for me.
And just because above game, I want to know, This is not a guard that the party had interacted with previously, right?
No, this is
the 22.
This is like a very large gentleman. Like, he's almost at eye with guard 7, like in height. He's like large,
he's gonna try
fully
and punch
plate
him,
armor. He's like just huge. What was it? Sorry?
It's a 22. I got that.
22?
The extra persuasion from that.
You gave him more persuasion.
He looks at you and he says, "Little lizard man, this is from the mayor.
We just went.
Come with me. Dr. I will, for your friend's sake here, because I wish to be peaceful, I won't put you in handcuffs as long as you walk with us. Is that a deal?"
That is deal. Otherwise, this will get bloody.
I wouldn't make threats, friend.
His eyes are like glowing softly red. It is not threat. It is fact.
I don't like the energy we created in this room here.
The guy looks around and he's just like, this isn't a room.
Should I have mentioned Dono Guard 7's chaotic code?
It's an expression, mate. I'm not... Of course it's not a room. We're outside, you idiot.
But I didn't do anything wrong.
Merish, we will get this figured out. Lead on.
He looks at some of the guards and kind of like points towards you, and they begin to flank you as well, just because of your threats.
Sheath my sword.
Okay. Thank you. We'll do this as peaceful as possible. I wish not to shed any blood as well, if possible. And they begin to take you to what is...
Did Babylon just get like wrangled with us?
Yeah.
Sorry, bud.
Hey. I should close my tea shop. My caravan is technically still open for business. I should close that up.
We'll send somebody for you. What does it look like?
Tented caravan. There's a couple of oxen on the front.
All right. He looks at one of the guards that like they walk by, and he just kind of.
Yeah, full of jars of tea, dry tea.
Okay. All right. Send somebody out there to go get it taken care of and such. You guys are brought in front of what is, I believe,
Rich.
It would be what the courthouse, where the jail would be. And he says, "You'll be here. We'll safely put you within a cell for a little bit. Until we're ready to meet with you."
Or we stand here in courtyard and
right
wait.
Now.
You wish to stand here in courtyard?
I do not
trust cells.
Make a persuasion check. Are you intimidating?
I'm just persuading. He's not. He's trying not to be scary at this point, because the guy said he's also willing to be peaceful. Ooh. Let's see. Do I have anything on persuasion? Nope, that's a 13. Straight up and down.
I want to speak to the mayor now. I want to get this cleared up. I have fish coming.
I do not taste things.
Just for reference,
Donovan,
I since Merish still doesn't know the value of gold, he marked off 5 gold for that fish.
Okay. The guy didn't accept the money.
Oh.
He said that you didn't need to pay for it.
I'll put it back.
Okay.
Dono, question.
Gentlemen, yes.
Because I would have assumed there'd be, if we're seeing guards, there would have been guards on the dock. Were any of them actually helping with the fire?
Yeah, they were.
Okay.
Yeah, it was chaotic, but you could definitely see people that were like in guard uniforms and such like that. It seemed to be more recent, so it was like really quick actions and such, and so it was like minimal damage to a large building. So,
okay.
Hope that makes sense. He goes to you and just says, "Friend, I understand. I get it. But as protocol calls for it, I need you to come in here and go just wait in a cell for me.
I will
wait with you outside the cell and make sure nobody fucks with you. If that is something that you concern."
This is acceptable. Okay. Come, Merish. We will sit.
Merish is turning a real dark shade of, I gotta remember what it is.
black.
I gotta figure out like what the colors of his eyes mean.
Holy shit, you can change color?
Yeah, Babylon, Guard 7's eyes have also been changing colors.
And he is just like
we're both mood ring characters. God, actually, Drunk, can you send me your color guide?
Yeah.
Because I'll just use the same thing.
Oh yeah, I forgot that I sent
it's,
that.
It's pretty basic. Dono sent it to me.
But yeah, so Guard 7's
thanks
just
for
gonna
the
like
follow, by the way, Department of Adventures.
Yeah, thank you.
My eyes are stuck at this like lime green shit. That's
why
amazing.
What are you talking about? My eyes are always one color.
So, you guys are brought within
just change color.
You guys are now having this conversation within the cell as yeah. The large
Guard 7 is gonna like find a
guard
seat.
Guard character is like sat down on like the small little bench.
He's
he just has like his sword.
The tiniest
like
little prayer book and open it. The internal combustion engine. The prayer book of Nayla is a manual for like mechanical stuff. And building constructs and such.
That is amazing.
I knew that would break Dono. I fucking love it.
Just Merish is nervously pacing the cell.
Okay.
Top dead center should be rotation, but only if made in 1964.
How many degrees before top dead center?
I don't remember the whole thing. I just love the reference.
You'll pin the motor at 28 degrees before top dead center.
Perfect.
Ensuring your harmonic balancer pulling your crank.
Yeah, so his eyes have just returned to that like sky blue.
Just no, like I'm definitely jet black at this point.
Yeah. See, they did it again. They changed color again.
I did not know my eyes changed color. My builders did not tell me that I had features like that.
Cool.
Well, they're assholes then, if they didn't tell you that.
They were very busy. Eyes the brothers of the temple, always building, building, building. Very, very busy people.
It takes 2 seconds to tell someone their eyes changed color.
There's like 30 of us. They probably were going to tell us all at once.
Fair enough. Just saying, if my eyes could change color like that, I'd be well impressed.
Do my eyes change color?
No, your whole body changes color.
Yeah, your scales are black. Are you okay?
No, I'm not okay. I didn't do anything wrong.
We will get this figured out. Why did they say you were not supposed to leave city?
Well, there was an incident at the tap keg, and we went and stayed somewhere else, and then Briar got us permission to go see Dr. Kor.
Hmm. Who did Briar get permission from?
She said it was the mayor.
We will figure out.
I didn't do anything.
I trust you.
They told me that it was okay that I protected people, and Merish start looking very
He's literally going to pick Merish up, put him on his knee, and do like the dad rocking on the knee thing. Okay. Just rubbing his back like it will be okay. We will get this figured out. And then you cook giant fish. I will even attempt to consume. Dono is trying so hard not to laugh.
I'm loving the interaction so goddamn much. I love it.
Yeah, so I'm the chaotic good dad robot. Fuck, I'm Robin Williams in Bicentennial Man.
We broke Dono.
Isn't that the goal? You win if you break the DM, right?
Oh, in this way.
So yeah, he's just gonna try and comfort Merish.
So, is there anything
and help calm him down?
Want to do besides the interactions? Are you guys wanting to talk? Okay. So a little bit of time passes, and you do see the mayor come down with his. As you remember, he is a redheaded gentleman, red beard. He looks like a little bit of portly, but he's also got, he's very much dad bod situation. Big, strong, wears the button shirt, tie, looks as like he's a bit scruffy, but there together. Fuck, what's the name of the, if I remember, his name is Neville, I believe. Let me check here. I have it somewhere. Oh, yes. No. Why the fuck do I not have the rest of it typed up? I believe his name is Neville. If I remember correctly. If somebody in the chat knows better, then let me know. But I believe his name is Neville. He looks at you and says, well, where'd you go?
We got permission to go see Dr. Cora.
I didn't give permission.
We were told, I was told it was you.
Do you,
there was a letter and everything
that you're told?
Yeah.
He's 14.
Who are you?
I am Guard 7.
This is Guard 7. Guard 7, this is...
are you impersonating a guard?
No.
In my town?
No, my name is Guard 7.
Dad, but I didn't do anything.
My name's Babylon.
Pat.
I just changed accent.
Pat.
I just changed accent, like, completely spontaneously.
Hi.
That's okay. I do that constantly.
He looks at the guy in the armor and says, only one of these people I told you to get. It's like, they told me that they all wanted to be in there together.
No, I said I wanted to wait in the courtyard. You told me you would wait with us if we
went
in here.
It helps the child.
Mama Owens. Mama Owens knew where we went.
Who is Mama Owens?
Yeah, who is Mama Owens?
We even pay for a boat. If we couldn't leave, why would they let us pay for a boat?
We would have had to have paid the dockmaster, right?
You paid the people that took you on the ship.
I thought we arranged passage with the dockmaster, who then paid.
Yes, but you pay the people that you are renting the ship from and that are doing the job for you. The dockmaster takes like a small sum after the job is
but
done.
Wouldn't the dockmaster also be aware of who's not supposed to leave town?
You guys literally left the morning after.
Fuck, you're right, yeah. Also, it is so hard not to metagame with other characters' knowledge.
So at that point, I played it as literally no one else had been told anything, and the situation was still brand new. So you got, like, that was, like, perfect time to leave and not
you
have to deal
have
with anything.
Should left and never come back after, you know, saving people's lives.
He just looks at you and like, well, looks like we're going to be questioning Miss Owens, because she wasn't, she didn't come up in any kind of conversation before. And looks at one of the guards and takes him off, or, like, asks him to go do that.
Why were you looking for Merish?
And did he not tell you? Two
I
guards
only met him
died.
2 days ago. Only one of the
in
guards
town,
died.
Only one guard died.
Oh, only
yeah.
One.
He killed one guard,
guard,
the other one we
three
subdued.
Guards. Okay, so let me fix that. One guard died, thanks to this little man. Two of them.
I was saving people's lives.
Merish, let him finish. We will figure out what is going on.
And the other two turned in to these different creatures that we cannot seem to fix in any way, and we are currently figuring that out. You, near the little group, was asked to stay so we could investigate and ask questions.
But then our group got permission.
From who?
I don't know. We were on a mission.
From who?
What did she call it? She called it something.
Yeah, Briar said the name of the order, didn't she?
She
I don't think we have... I
order.
Don't have it in my notes.
I'll just go with the order. The order sent us to go see Dr. Kor.
Do you have proof of the order asking you to do this?
No, but I have Dr. Kor. We're adventuring for Dr. Kor now. That's where we were.
He asked, do you have proof of any of this?
I do.
As far as we're concerned, you left.
I do. I have a letter.
Like, didn't? Who had the documentation? Because...
Briar is
who had the bag.
From my understanding, Briar is wearing the coat of holding.
Yeah.
Briar would have everything.
Also,
on
if
her.
Briar had to go through town, wouldn't she have been picked up already too? And already have shown them the documentation?
No.
Send word to Dr. Didn't he give us some way to communicate with him?
I have no idea. I wasn't paying attention to that most of that episode because I wasn't in it.
He did, but it's the frickin' coat that Briar has.
Fuck. Fantasy, why did you have to volunteer to help people?
Go ask Yip. Yip was there.
Where is Yip?
Yip went home. I think. He did this whole thing and went Yip, Yip.
He looks at the... He just looks kind of at the guards and goes, all right. Continues to kind of just... He's just continuing to get you to just talk.
Merish,
communicate.
Question. Why would you have killed a guard?
We can just assume that at this point it is explained of what happened.
I get a very sad expression on my face and said, I didn't mean to kill him. Just trying to save people.
It seems to me guards cease to be guard when turned into monster. Therefore, it is not murder, it is just adventuring without a license when destroying monster.
I understand your logic there, friend.
You're a nice enough kid. I'm guessing you...
Also, should take into account the fact that the moment we got back in town, we helped prevent warehouse burning down.
And we appreciate that. But criminals will do a lot of different things to get the smoke off of them.
To suggest he is criminal suggests crime. At most, he commit fraud.
He was told not to leave, and then left.
I'm telling you we got permission.
Do you have documentation of writ of non-transference?
He pulls out a
document that says you're not allowed to leave.
Yeah. Basically, that, like, it was an order that was that, like, these people, it has written down Merish, Briar, Yip, and then Jerry Barry. Which, and then he goes, by the way, where's Jerry?
I don't want to talk about that.
Who is Jerry? I do not know this person.
Jerry is my friend.
Wait, the one that, how did you put it, douchebag frog hurt?
Yes.
Ah. Jerry is rage monster.
Make a persuasion check on that one.
Oh, 17.
Ooh, okay. What do you mean by rage monster? As he kind of like gives this face of like interest.
Jerry is in no position to travel, and that is all that needs to be said.
Make an intimidation roll on that one.
Guard is going to give the small explanation that he was given of essentially a disease took him, and now he is...
That is a...
rage monster. I think that's roughly what
15? Okay. He doesn't seem to be very intimidated by your anger. In any way.
It's more sadness than anger.
Yeah. Or your aggression.
It's like
aggression,
a 13-year-old yelling
anger
at their
parent. Or sadness, so. Aggression. Your aggressive act. Or your kind of push. He looks at the situation and goes, I'll be back in a second. And goes to go upstairs.
You're gonna make us break out of jail.
Yeah.
Get in the caravan! How fast can these oxen go? Half a mile an hour.
is Neville gone?
No, so back on subject, I believe you were asking if the mayor had left.
Yeah, okay. So I turn back to is it Rakesh?
Merish.
Merish. I turn back to Merish and I just go, Maris.
He just likes to hold the S and H.
Maris. Okay, alright, what happened there? What happened? Accent change again.
Are we actively noticing that his voice is changing? Like, is that in character that his voice is changing and we're noticing it?
I will let him decide if that's what's going on.
Yeah, he's not hiding the fact that it did change. Like, okay. Without explanation, he just went straight, like, full from deep south talking to Neville and then straight back into West Country England to you.
Hmm.
Weird. What are you wanting to know?
All I know is that there's apparently one guard's been killed, but he was turned into something else, so...
Me and Jerry were staying at the Tapped Keg.
Jerry and I.
Me and Jerry.
No,
I was cooking,
grammar.
He was performing, it was the festival, and it was a lot of fun. Well, the last night of it, I had just got done cooking, and I sat down and was watching Jerry's performance, and three of the guards just changed. They started attacking everybody. And so, I was just trying to help.
So this wasn't, like, they attacked you specifically? It was like, they were attacking everyone in the bar?
They stabbed the bartender! He's my friend!
Hmm.
That can't be good. Okay, well, regardless of what happens here, this is a tricky situation here, because by technicality, they were still guards, even if their mind was gone.
Yes, but at the same time, they have given up guard position by attacking innocents. This is very complicated.
Well, that makes sense as well. If they were going to start attacking people willy-nilly like that,
anyone who doesn't have a value on life doesn't value the life they have.
Merish, that is a very good idea, but you need calm. Calm mind will solve this.
That's a good saying to live by, but...
She has Dr. Cord's note. And the note from the mayor.
What? Why would guards suddenly turn into monsters? Was there something else that happened before this?
I don't know, but the same thing happened to Jerry. And I get that real sad expression on my face again.
What happened to Jerry? What caused that to happen?
Yes. Yes. You said it was like disease.
Frog guy.
Did he poison him?
Nikolai.
It was some sort of
the game note that we put in was literally Nikolai-douchefrog.
It was some sort of curse, and we tried to remove it.
Very intense note-taking here at A&I.
Very intense. We're so detailed.
We tried.
As time passes...
I'm like feeling like real emotion for fucking losing Jerry.
So it's not outside of the realm that what happened to Jerry also happened to those guards.
Which is why we need to get out of here.
How would guards have been infected by monster or by, as you say, douche frog?
I don't know.
Not specifically the frog. Something that can come out of... You know frogs can be poisonous or venomous, right? What if someone got hold of the poisonous or venomous qualities of said frog and transferred it into, let's say, their drinks?
I think it was some sort of magic.
Magic could work as well, but it's some...
Just because I'm trying really hard to lead Merish to the right answer because he knows this. Help. Because Merish would know he would have figured out the connection, right?
I don't know.
The pig monsters. Did you forget, Drunk?
I remember the pig
episode
monsters.
One.
There you
they
go.
The pig monsters.
I didn't know if you forgot or if Merish just didn't know.
I remember fighting the pig monsters, but Merish, neither me nor Merish clicked that together.
Yeah, like, I would think Merish like, would have made the connection of, shocked. Oh, they're acting like they, because they literally, Dono described them as turning into the same monsters, right?
So, just that shocked expression they took, like, on Merish's face.
Pieces of it, and, like,
but
so
it was
like,
similar enough that,
the,
like,
yeah.
Yeah.
And then, like, the way that they, like, physically interacted with things, it was the same.
Just that shocked expression on Marish's face. Guard, get Neville back here.
He's right there, and he's just like, "I'm."
You're yelling in his face as he's just like sitting with a book. Reading.
I just remembered something. Get Neville.
Okay, calm down. You're fine. And he goes to begin. Like you just hear ching 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 as he's like walking up the stairs. You guys are now alone underneath this in this prison cell area, or is it jail cell? It's not prison; it's a jail.
It's a jail. No, I'm like the whole time I'm trying to ask questions as guard so that you'll remember shit and make connections as Merish because I don't want to metagame. But, oh, God damn it! You know this.
I did remember the fight, but neither me nor Merish.
Yeah, because the guards got infected the same as Jerry. I was just trying not to say it outright in character.
Just the difference was that Jerry got infected by the source.
Yeah.
Or what you guys believe to be the source. I guess.
The same infection reached him in some way, but.
Yep. Alright. So. Some time passes. And not only is Neville brought, but you also see a woman that has long black hair. A black in clothing. She is tall, or she is not tall. She's about 5'9", probably within her 30s. Beautiful, well, not taken care of. And she holds like a symbol on her chest. And she walks down with you. And behind them is Briar with a purple coat, completely white hair pulled up. Almost canine features, a little bit showing, and they walk down, and Neville goes, "All right." Looks at a piece of paper. Unlock the cell.
Trevor, Briar, hi.
Who the fuck is Trevor?
Who the fuck is Trevor?
Neville.
Just a little frog bounces past Neville's feet. Trevor!
That had to be why I said that.
That's what I
He's
figured.
He's our frog!
I mean, we're talking about frog people, too.
Neville. Come on, Trevor. Neville. You're a manly frog.
Neville, I remembered something. Oh. I know how the guards got turned.
Neville just looks over. Yes, Briar already explained it.
All right. He goes, please do tell.
When we went to the island and we encountered the frog people.
Grung.
And one of them was turning creatures and cursing them. And it spread it to Jerry. Don't ask, just listen. And that's what happened to the guards. They were the ones that were helping us fight the pig people that night. Anyone who comes in contact can be turned. Who else has come in contact?
So far, we've actually kept the infection down. And it seems that those guards were the ones that were unable to, I don't know what it is, but if it's a turning and a curse, that would make more sense of why it's so hard to cure them of it, because we've sent them with some of our best healers and cures. We've also swept everybody as well. We had, and he points to the woman with the black, with the jet black hair and frame, or beautiful frame. Like, we had Diana here go around and start healing people and using restoration magic to the best of her ability in order to check for people that had maybe shown signs. And it seems like if you can catch it before a 24-hour mark, you can save somebody. But if but it seems like with those guards, it was too late. We still haven't figured out how to change them back from where they are. But
let us go so we can go hunt.
He stops you and he's just like, he reads off this thing that says, as order by, or from order of the order of hunters, you have been amended of your crimes. And it's just like this whole list of just basically telling them, you guys are no longer in trouble because you actually did a thing for the order, or the hunters here, part of Laxos. Diana comes up to you and be like, I am one of the captains of the hunters. I am Grave Cleric Diana. Thank you for your help. I appreciate it. And I'm sorry for your friend.
I would say Briar would probably chime in, just because I know Fantasy would want to point it out, and explain that Dr. Kor has Jerry contained and is... Because Kor had said he was going to research what was going on, and just suggest that they get in contact with him and try and coordinate efforts.
Mm-hmm. She says, if there's anybody that can figure out something, it's him. I have a feeling that this is a little more stronger than what we want it to be.
From my understanding, the frog person in question who was doing this has fled south, and that is where party planned to go.
After a good night's rest and a good meal, of course.
Well, that's fine. You guys can go. Rest is when you close your eyes and allow yourself to dream.
He stares at Diana, who I'm assuming was talking, with his eyes that do not blink or have eyelids.
Do robots drink of and dream of electric sheep?
Yeah, his eyes are literally like crystal plates in what appears to be a helmet.
Thank you for the subscription, Department of Adventures.
Thank you for subscribing.
Thank you.
His eyes, like, turn yellow for a second while he thinks about what Diana said, and then just back to green.
Now, sorry for wasting your time. Please get things that you need together and continue on your way. I am sure that he's probably headed for the mountains, if you want my advice.
And that's where we're going.
She says, from Briar's understanding and what she's told me, you guys already kind of have a direction of where you're wanting to go and figuring things out, so I won't give you too much information. Just thank you, and good luck from here on out. And jail cell is open. You guys are allowed out, and you may do as you wish.
Let's go to the tapped keg and get Babylon his chocolate wasted milk. No, Dono. I've finally done it. I made a character that can't get drunk.
That's brilliant.
In short circuit, though.
Exactly. I made a character that can't drink.
Yeah.
My characters are normally the alcoholics.
All right, so you guys make it to the tapped keg. It is not exactly dead, but there's like a few patrons in there. It's about a little bit later in the day. And Yip is there as well, chatting with George or Joe.
You shall never know who's the one who subbed.
It's Stealthy. Or Geeks. Or Mel. Yeah. It's not Sky. It's the one person. I know it's not Sky.
Yeah. Okay, so... We're all back together. We're at the tap keg. Let me go back to my notes. Okay, so Joe, hi, man. Hi. Did my fish get here yet?
How was your guys' little? I see you finally got out of the jail cell.
My scales are still that jet black nervous look to me. And
how is your little party out and about? You lose.
We're not gonna talk about that right now. Fish here.
Ooh, thanks for the 7K bits, Tubbsy. The 1K bits. Why did I say 7K bits?
Yeah, Tubbsy gave us 500 bits and earned a 1K bits badge, which we don't have.
Oh, okay, cool.
So you get the generic one.
So is my fish here?
Yes, actually.
Can I borrow your kitchen? I'd like to cook for my new friend.
Okay. Yeah, sure. What?
Guard and Babylon just look at each other trying to figure out which one he's talking about.
Okay.
He didn't use he used a singular, not a plural.
Just one friend.
Fine. Guard will go sit in the corner.
24 for my dex check.
Oh, you fucking totally. Check. You make a beautiful meal. What are you making out of this fish? It is a large, about 3 foot long, what's a swordfish?
Freshwater lake?
It is a... So, I've explained this before.
Oh, no, you have, because the lake connects into the sea, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's like a sink situation, so you can get some saltwater fish within this lake water as well.
We will...
I would just go with salmon. Salmon ginger, can do garlic, both fresh and roasted salt.
Swordfish with a creel kick.
Got it.
Wait, he has the cookbook. Are there fish recipes in the cookbook? Can we get a buff out of this?
Do you want... Drunk can share the cookbook if he wants. Yeah, I'm not going to...
Let me bring the cookbook. Do that
if you want. Exactly normal creatures. You guys would actually have to go...
Oh, yeah, because it uses...
It's like a monster hunter cookbook.
Yeah, so it uses monster parts. Crate dragon meat.
It's using monster parts to make like potions and such like that.
You guys know the YouTuber Kenku, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like his video.
Yeah. It's crazy. Thank you, Trans Rainbow, for...
Taste the Rainbow.
Oh, taste the Rainbow. Why am I not able to fucking read this?
Literally, Dono, the worst part? That's Ruth. You play Among Us with them.
You know what?
You should join us for Among Us one of these nights, Pete.
Okay, there you go.
I can get it on my phone. I can play it for free with you guys.
Yeah, do that. There's plenty that do that. Fuck.
Okay. Oh. Cut tangent here.
I'm so sorry.
I'm going to leave so much of this in because it's just too entertaining.
The
podcast is going to be so confusing because we're talking about the stream stuff.
But... Was my roll high enough to give him a buff, Donna?
Yes. You guys can each roll a d4.
Ooh. I'll roll my bloody d4. Wait, do I have the really nice?
Briar got a 2.
I want it.
Actually, wait, what was the, bottom of that roll before you add modifiers?
17.
Okay, so I'll allow it this time, but it needs to be a little bit higher next time. But yeah, so take that D4, add it to your HP.
Sweet.
It's a temporary buff.
I get one temp HP. Hey, one temp HP? I know I'm a barbarian, but still, that's handy.
It's
been a minute since I've gotten a high enough roll to get us one. So
That's half of one unarmed attack against me while raging.
So in future, Drunk, it is... either a 19 or a 20 base roll. So it's literally, so if you roll on the die a 19 or a 20, it's not if you make 19 or 20, it's if you roll a 19 or a 20.
Okay.
Then they can add with it an extra thing. So that's just a little thing that I give to people that want to take the little cook's background. So
that's a good bump.
Oh my goodness. Choo-choo. Goodness. Okay. Oh, he's giving so much right now. Love it. Thank you. Everybody that's giving bits and things and gifts and love it. Okay. You guys have a delicious meal tonight. Anything that you guys want to chat about, whatnot, or do you guys want me to roll into what is basically the next... All right. What is your guys' plans for tomorrow?
I would have figured over dinner guard was gonna like try and get to know Babylon, just be like,
so I noticed your voice was very weird around mayor. Why is this?
You know too much, and I ducked under the table. No, I'm kidding. I do that because I know some people, and some people know me, and I don't want my voice getting dispersed around, my details getting dispersed around. I have a history, all right? I don't want to get too much into it, but people know me, so...
As long as it does not endanger us, no problem.
It won't endanger you. I work for someone who wasn't the most respectable of people.
Did you work for the terrifying lich?
What? No, I work for someone completely differently.
All right. Why not question? You tell us when you're ready.
Yeah, Babylon. Not really a sort of a first day sort of thing.
So, Pete, if you want, you can totally make a history check with the lich comment.
History.
I figure if I mention a lich, there has been one. So it's something that
That's an 8.
Okay, now. You don't remember anything, so...
No, it
doesn't come to mind. You're a little flustered and everything. It's just like, lich, what the fuck are you talking about?
I don't know any lich that you're on about.
He worked for the tea sellers union.
No, that was that's a more recent gig.
Why you travel and sell tea?
Yeah, I sell loose tea to people. It's a nice respectable business. I get to travel wherever I want. You don't need a permit if your wagon is constantly on the move. So that's why I always keep my oxen tied up to it. If they're ready to go, I can't get kicked off.
Merish, have you ever used tea for cooking?
No.
I have been told tea tastes good. I do not know myself.
I will say, the portion of fish in front of him is like... the way he ate is literally, he picks it up, opens the faceplate, and drops it, and you hear like a garbage disposal-like sound.
One piece is just like a little bit good? Larger, and you just have to like punch it in. You get, like, a little stick out, and you just...
No. He closes the face mask, and if you've ever heard a trash compactor, just... I'm gonna get a soundboard eventually for this shit.
God.
Just push a button.
So, you guys have a conversation.
But
if you're getting rooms for the night... being that you guys, well, you Merish, your returning customer, and you used to work for him, it is 5 silver per night. So,
5 silver?
Yeah, anybody that's taking a night at the inn, mark that off.
Is Babylon staying at the inn, or is he gonna...
I've got my own bed, but I might as well stay somewhere that has actual heating. So,
then I'll just toss, I'll give 2 gold to cover 4 rooms.
Okay. Thanks, buddy.
You're on the map. If there are enough rooms that they can do that. I know there's a few. Where are my pictures? God damn it. Oh, there
it is. God didn't need to damn it. He could walk on water.
You know what?
That is such a Missouri joke. Shit, my 1 point of temporary HP is gone. I didn't take bear totem. I don't have protection against everything but psychic.
Where did I... No, what the hell?
Though, I need to look at something. Pictures.
It should I'll be NPC, right?
Damned.
Okay. Alright, there are only three rooms ultimately available, unless you guys want to pay for the larger room that has a few beds in it and a fireplace, which that one is actually 2 gold.
And that one would fit all of us?
Yeah.
Then, yeah.
It might be a little cramped, but it's like a loft room. So it's like very top, very large, and it has like a little fireplace in it. So
yeah, then I'd cover that with the 2 gold. Okay.
So to describe this room, it has several different beds. Each one of them has like a small wall situation. So they're like twin beds. There's a small little throw carpet or throw rug, right next to the fireplace. Fireplace is just like a stone, simple. It's kept, but not like polished or anything like that. And you guys do get a decently good sized closet in this room as well. And there are enough beds for every single person, and to close off, like to gain privacy to the beds, there's a small curtain area.
Oh, it's a bunk room.
Yeah. So you just have like your own individual spaces, but then there's like the living corner space, and there is like a small kind of like kneeling table that you'd see in like Japanese kind of places, but like it's a coffee table, basically. It's okay, not really yeah, I eating, know what you're talking
about.
Yeah, so.
Yeah.
And then, like, stone brick walls all around you. And then there's a large window out that you can see out to the streets and buildings around you.
Cool.
Yeah. Thought you would like that. Okay.
He's a nice place. Guard is going to go sit in a corner. Just face the rest of the room for 6 hours. His eyes are just empty.
All right.
Merish is going to go drop his bag in the closet, and you hear the clang of his pots and knives. And
ding, 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 ding.
Then go crawl up into the highest bed possible.
They're not bunk beds. They're like singular like rooms like that are twin size. Like you have a little bit of, like you have probably about 2 feet in between the bed and the wall, and then there's a curtain. That covers
all
it.
All right.
Then you get, like, basic bedding. So.
We have a long day tomorrow.
Like an officer's room on a sub.
Yeah. I guess. I'll agree to that, I guess. I've never seen an officer's room on a sub before. But I'll agree to it. Sure. A
really old one.
Okay. Yeah.
There's literally a submarine permanently docked at a museum here in Portland that you can, like, go on.
Yeah, I've been to two. One in South Carolina, one in Oklahoma. It is literally a submarine that was basically put into a field and a museum was made into it.
That sounds cool.
All right.
Babylon just puts his hat on the bedside table, and not even getting under the covers, just flops face first onto the bed.
Ah, the tired college student method of sleep.
Yes. Fully clothed.
I'm having flashbacks.
God, I'm going to be having flashbacks in 10 years.
I can admit
I'm not that much older than you, God.
I can admit,
no,
I've done...
I'm just saying, like 10, 15 years from now, I'm going to be looking back at, like, what my sleep schedule is at the moment. You're going to be going, God, what was I thinking?
Yes, because your sleep schedule would be better by then.
Freaking, when I was in college, I've done a lot of hardworking jobs, but I think college was the only thing where I actually was able to, like, just pass out. At one point, like that, I only once, and it only happened once, and it was during college. I just laid down on the bed, just passed out for like 12 hours. I was like, fuck!
Past few days, like,
if you guys want, we can take a 5-minute break.
Yeah, I was going to say, probably a good idea.
Go to the bathroom, do what you need to. We will be right back with Adventures Initiative. Please enjoy the break. Love you all. Stick around. Mwah.
Thank you for watching and or listening to Adventures in Initiative. If you're enjoying the show, please consider sharing it with others and giving us a like, review, or follow. You can watch us live on Saturdays at 2:30 p.m. PST at twitch.tv/adventures_and_initiative. Thanks again from all of us at A&I. Now back to the show.
Welcome back to Adventures Initiative. I hope you enjoyed your break. We are coming into the group sleeping. And now I need everybody except for our guests to mute themselves. I guess, Shop, you have to listen, don't you?
Yeah, I'll take my headphones off. I'll take my headphones off and just wave at
I'll
me.
I'll point to the ears when you're ready to listen, but this is my favorite part about warlocks.
Yeah.
As you pass out and go to sleep, you awaken into an evergreen forest. An archway is given, and you see your patron standing there at a table, a teapot sat, and teacups put on. They are gold-rimmed, beautifully porcelain-made, and he merely says, "Take a seat, my friend."
Good night. And I sit down with him.
All right. So, anything new from the last we met? As he kind of crosses his legs, I imagine he has like this green robe that passes. What kind of fae is he? Is he an elf fae?
I don't.
I'll say that he looks elven in features, but height is very tall. He towers over you as he stands. His hair is like blonde, flowing all around. Eyes are golden, and he just looks at you and says, "So, anything new from the last we met?"
Well, I've been talking to a bunch of new people that came around. Met them while trying to put out a fire from a warehouse, and apparently one of them killed a couple guards, and they got thrown in jail for like 2 minutes, and then they got thrown back out of jail again because they apparently killed two guards that turned into something, so that they were doing them a favor.
His eyes kind of widen and ear turns and perks to you and looks to like a little plant creature that seems to be walking on the table, and he just says, "Two sugars." As like two cube sugars get plopped into the teacup, and he pours hot tea into it. "Would you like some?"
"Yes, thank you very much. Four sugars, please."
Plant comes by, four sugars, throws them into the cup and pours the tea. That sounds quite interesting. Do you trust these people?
No, not one bit.
he chuckles.
They noticed my voice change. I'm giving them this one at the moment, my classic old farmer. But
it's convincing.
They saw me do one talking to the mayor of that town. They saw me go all deep south on them, and there's this one guy, a robot. He picked up on that right away, and I don't really want to tell him much about that. I'm sure you will understand.
Understandable. Do you think you could trust them enough to do a quest?
I think so.
All right. He takes his finger, it glows slightly, points it to your forehead, and you seem to have like a little bit of like a flash come between your eyes. And he says, "That will point you to me. I need you to do something. Also, come here quickly before the two full moons happen." And for your understanding, this world has two moons on it. And they're like, basically what he's referring to is that the moon, like both of them will be full at the same time. Instead of waiting for two whole full moons to happen, it is before the two moons become full.
All right.
All right.
Yeah.
now. If you don't, you can finish your tea, and I will see you soon. And you guys just kind of sit there and enjoy your tea for a moment. It's like, any questions that you might have? And you guys just start to have a lovely conversation.
Yeah.
And now I will make eye contact with Shop. Shop.
He's looking down.
Stop looking at me! Shop. Put your headphones in. Welcome back. Okay. You can change the music back to whatever you wish. Whatever our normal background music is. Okay. All right. You guys wake up and you come to morning, light coming in through this big pane, that window to the side of the room. For those that have drawn curtains or whatever, it doesn't pierce through very much except for small slits. Who would like to be the first? Well, actually, Shop. Nah, Guard 7 would probably be the first to wake up because he only has a 6 hours. So before everybody wakes up, what would you like to do for a second? Okay. Make me a general wisdom.
Oh, sorry, I was muted.
Just make me a general wisdom check for me.
Wisdom check, okay. Wisdom. Oh, actually, I have decent modifier on that.
Since like starting a fire is more survival and such, but like using
is it
the things.
Survival or wisdom?
I'll allow survival. You guys aren't exactly out in the wild, but it's
the proficiency is appreciated.
I'm trying to help.
Nine.
Basically, you're using the things around you.
Yeah, that's a nine.
Building around, you get the logs in there. You have like a stick, and you just kind of like sit there for a second, and you just kind of like
rub the stick on the logs. Is this how it goes?
Well, it's like the metal rod poker that you have. You're just like, I missed a step here.
There should be fire. So he was not a construct made. The Temple of Nayla, where he's from, they have constructs that were made to, like, be servants, start fires, bring meals, all that stuff. That was not his job, but he was around fleshies enough. I need to think of a much better term. Long
that's
enough.
That's actually a perfectly fine that term.
Mortals? I mean, technically he is immortal as long as he doesn't die.
He's immortal. It's fleshy is fine. I think fleshy works well.
He's been around the flesh bags long enough to know they do not like cold.
Meat sacks.
I think fleshies is a little bit better than like meat sacks or whatever.
Yeah.
You're trying to start a fire and you're just like,
He's just like, I know the logs in this, but no.
Yawn. Let me help.
Good morning,
like,
Merish.
Like,
he's literally, for 2 hours, just been standing there staring at it, going back and forth. There is something else I'm
supposed
Merish to do.
Merish just walks up and just goes, and there's a bonfire.
You're really going to use bonfire? It's kind of
great
a
great bonfire.
Is it create cantrip. Bonfire a level 1 spell?
It's a cantrip.
Is it?
Cantrip.
Oh, cool.
I think bonfire.
I know create fire is a cantrip.
Create bonfire.
Is it create bonfire 5
like
five
it's big
square?
That's a this is a decent sized fireplace, and if you wanted to put it like on
is
the
is this
wall
like a
first,
walk into
it
big
like
fireplace?
Huh?
Is it like a walk into it big fireplace?
Or is it like a log burner?
It's like a log burner. It's, if you're small enough, you can walk into
flame.
It. But, like, freaking Sacred Flame wouldn't work. Sacred Flame is like...
Yeah.
What about Flaming Sphere?
You're a warlock. You don't have many spell slots. Let's focus on bonfire. Because it only lasts...
Fireball.
Well,
just
it
fireball.
Also,
nothing but fireball.
it also only lasts a minute if you hold the concentration, but any flammable objects are ignited. So he could just, like, not concentrate and poof it. So there's just that, like, if you've ever, like, been trying to light a propane grill and the gas has been running but your thing's not sparking, then all of a sudden, poof, the fireball in your face.
What's the diameter of a flaming sphere?
It's a 5-foot fireball in guard seven's face. Should I roll the dex save it requires?
No, he's just. I'll allow Merish just.
Well, no, because it's an either or for damage. Either I succeed or I take 1d4 fire damage.
Great bonfire is 1d8.
Yeah, 1d8.
Oh shit!
But it's an either or spell, so it's either you take damage or you don't.
Is it like within a 5-foot radius of you?
Or until the spell ends, the magic bonfire fills a 5-foot cube. Any creature in the bonfire's space when you cast the spell must succeed on a dexterity saving throw or take 1d8 fire damage.
Fuck it, make a dex save for me.
Yeah, that, I was wanting it. It's
neither
fun. Imagine,
guys, if you're
okay with it, do it. I'm not going to say no.
Come on, plus one dex save. What's your spellcasting DC?
Like,
DC
13.
I'm just standing there. Merish walks up. Boof! I've got like the animated like charred face. Four damage.
12.
Oh, we lost our temp HP too. It goes away on long rests.
No, temp HP. So
temp HP only stays until you take a long rest, though, doesn't it?
Oh yeah. Wait. Yeah. Wait. I was thinking of something else. Never mind. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
Or until you have, like, another meal. So if you have, like, another big
somehow
meal,
managed to...
you can go away or switch out, depending.
Yeah. So I'm just imagining, like, his face is just charred in soot. Except
if he had eyebrows, they'd be gone.
Except, no. Because he has, like...
Wait.
We talked about...
He went from having no eyebrows to
Donno.
Now he has, like, charcoal marks
right
there on his face.
Donno, because remember, we talked about when he rages, all the, like, etchings on him pop up.
I don't think we talked about this, but yeah.
Oh, I wanted to do it for flavor. Essentially, his entire body, all the armor has etching on it. Mm-hmm. So when he rages, that lights up, but it's not normally visible because it's just light etching. The soot just reveals that he looks like it's like runic etching, almost tattoo-like, all over where the soot is. Think like a Maori-style tattooing, but with runic symbols. Yeah. And he does have two etched eyebrows.
Does Babylon succeed with a 13? Because
you're not even close to it, so you're fine.
Okay, good.
You're like still so asleep. Like I put it as like Merish woke up. He's just like threw a fucking.
That's what I was thinking.
Merish didn't even get out of bed
because I was asleep.
Because it has a 60-foot range.
Like because I was asleep, so I didn't want to be like shit. Rolls out of bed.
But as you do wake up Babylon and everybody else, along with Briar and Yip.
Thank you, Merish. I appreciate
Babylon,
the help.
As you wake up, you feel like a little warmth on your head, and everybody else can see it. But he has like a little bit, like his skin glows just a little bit right there on his forehead.
Right there.
Yeah, just like a little tiny dot. And you can feel like a pull. Like a pull into a direction.
What is, you have there is a thing on your face.
Oh, I was told to go and find someone. So, this is here directing me.
What direction is it telling you to go?
That way.
The western direction.
And I point like west out the window.
Yeah.
And which way are we headed?
You guys are headed west and then south. So if you're gonna take the road.
We're going the same direction.
Yeah.
You get to see this face more often then.
Right.
A little weird looking.
Would you like to travel with us? It is always safer in groups, right? That
sure
is what
enough,
I am told. My solo adventuring always made me get lost.
That's fair enough. I could definitely provide some cover with my caravan.
I lean into Briar and say, he's not allowed to look at the map.
Got it. You guys also begin
you
to hear...
Are you pointing at guard 7?
I am.
No.
As you said, you get lost.
You guys also begin to hear what sounds like a typewriter. Like a...
Just tap. It's me. I'm tapping on my keyboard.
Make a perception check.
All of us?
If you want to, yeah, all of you.
Ooh,
yeah.
That was a good one. 22.
It is coming, so that's good enough. It is coming from the coat that is hanging on a coat rack nearby.
Oh! We have, it's like one of those old teletype machines.
Briar, your coat appears to be tapping.
Yeah, I got it. Goes up to it, and there's like a little piece of paper that she rips out from the coat, and she just looks at it and is like, ah! Okay. And then, so on the coat, so you guys know, and put a note in the fucking thing here, you receive messages from the left pectorial pocket, and then you can send a note through the left. Or wait, right, no, left, you receive, right, you send. So like,
right, you write a note, left, they left you a note.
Yes, exactly.
After you take away the bread, lettuce, tomato, and mayonnaise, what do you have? A fax machine.
So if you guys need to send like a message to Dr. Core or asking him for some, or something, you can do that by sending it through the pocket. And there's like literally on the writing on the sides of it, like in, I think it's like Elven or whatever I put it as. Basically, it says send, receive on each peck. So if you guys ever need to send a message or something like that. But the note just says licenses added to inventory attached to persons. So at this time, and your inventory is the coat. So Briar goes to put in her hand into the coat, and Babylon, you see her put her hand in the coat, and it just like it seems like it just enters into nothing.
Whoa.
In the coat. And she's just not like thinks for a second, and then comes out with what seems to be three licenses or three pieces of, they look like little turtle shells. And on the back, yeah, or on not one side of it, it has the name Merish, Briar, and Yip on each one of them. And then official adventure party of Dr. Gary and Core.
Yes.
Should we get one for him?
You My were given a piece of paper to be able to, if you needed to add somebody, to do that, and then you would send that extra sheet to...
I'm asking Briar, should we get one for him?
Probably.
Yes, of course.
Yes, of course.
Well, I'll let you handle that.
Okay. Briar comes up to you and be like, guard, she comes up to you and she's just like, I'm guessing you're a part of the group now?
I hate to assume
I need you to sign this.
He just looks at it for a minute. Holds up his finger. A little quill tip comes out. And he signs his name. It'll never be anything game breaking or super useful, but he has, I want to say, he has little gadgets.
Swiss Army knife.
I'm thinking more Inspector Gadget style.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Just fingertip. Flip.
She folds it up. Yep. Sign it and just puts it in the pack, and it goes and disappears. We'll figure out how that goes in a little bit, in a while. You guys are each given, and since I gave Yip the identify spell, I would imagine that he's probably added it since he went to Zoans already. They identify it, and the cards actually go directly onto like a part of the body or our skin and looks as though it has a tattoo, but you can peel it off and show it. So in order to best transport it. But it only will go on to the person that it's supposed to go to. So you guys each get, it's basically a stick-on tattoo for each person, and it has your name and it's your private adventurer's license or your patron house. So if something goes wrong, guards need information. There's like, are you, like, identify your fucking selves. Why the hell have you blown up this building? explain yourselves. You pull that out there, and then they deal with all, like, financial shit with Dr. Ford. Or,
yeah. So, I'm sorry, Donna, your video...
Oh, is my audio going bad?
No, it's Zoom. It's locking primary speaker on somebody else, and because of that, it quiets everyone else. So you gotta get a
It's locking it on you, Shop.
Yeah, because I'm the host of the meeting.
Did you understand what that was that I said?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's essentially a tattoo so that we can just be like, oh, and it's whatever marking that shows we have the license.
Mm-hmm. And then you can take it off and it becomes a card again. So you can be able to hand it off to people, but it will only attach to the person that it is assigned to.
Oh, okay, I get the context now. Sorry, like the last 30 seconds, Donna, your audio just was slowly dipping out.
Super quiet.
I am terribly sorry. I will try to pick up my voice from here.
Yeah, I think it's because it's happening when you're leaning back, so it's not picking you up to mark you as speaker.
I will come closer.
I thought it was a connection.
No, it's Zoom.
I thought it was a connection thing at the beginning, but as it kept on going in and out, I finally sent a message to.
Yeah, I've been aware of it, and I'm trying to figure out how to fix it.
So wherever you guys would like to have that, it looks like a turtle shell is how he designed it.
Merish is gonna kind of do this whole look at it, and then kind of look, and then kind of do this whole spin around thing like the dogs do, trying to get his tail.
Merish, would you like to put on tail?
And then he realizes he can kind of just flick it up and stick it to the tail.
Right. And the next thing is that only the wearer can take it off. So, yeah. It's a little.
Did Babylon get one of these?
No. So this was previously discussed in like a previous episode, but within the laws of VALMIRAH, to be an adventurer and such. So like in case of like, because I'm going a little quicker than I need to. If shit goes bad and things get destroyed because of battles, fights, investigation, things are going in like a negative way, someone has to answer for that.
Right.
And to make sure that there's like payment made, etc., that is what these cards are for.
Yeah.
So basically... It is a sponsorship to become an adventurer because, and like adventuring parties, they can sponsor themselves. It's just easier to get somebody that has a lot of money to help you out. Because if shit goes wrong, someone's got to pay for it.
I see, yeah.
But there's always like set rules to contracts. Like if you go over a certain thing, you can lose your ability. So it's just something, because this is more of like a little bit more of a modern-ish campaign. Not modern, but like medieval knights and technology and shit like that, like the turn of the century kind of thing. That's what I kind of added to, because people would have seen that, oh, shit's going a certain way. We can't just let people run around willy-nilly saving people and then destroying our villages on top of it. So Red Dragon comes and blows up your town because adventurers decided to run out of his lair.
Somebody's got to pay for it.
Fuck with that.
Exactly. I see.
Okay, I think I've got it fixed. It had a setting that's supposed to like suppress intermittent and consistent background noise. So I think it was thinking your voice was background noise, so I shut that off.
Thanks, Zoom. Cool. Fuck you too.
Well, it's unfortunately, all of us kind of fall into this like lower voice range where that's what shit picks up as background noise.
Yeah. Yeah, we can't all talk like Jacksepticeye.
All right, everybody!
No, that's... fuck, what is his intro?
Top of the morning to you,
laddies! Top of the morning to you, laddies!
All right. So what would you guys like to do?
I'm surprised even I could hit that note.
I can't.
Breakfast!
All right, yeah, Merish is cooking breakfast, I guess.
We're having spam and eggs.
Okay.
Spam and egg burrito.
One right. silver for what you need to have for ingredients wise.
Okay.
Spam doesn't exist in this world.
Find something that is kind of like spam.
Canned meat. Haggis.
Haggis.
Done.
Let's follow my Scottish ancestors.
That is a
ish.
16.
16. It's a good meal. It's not fantastic, but it's good enough. It's enough to give you guys what you need, nutrition-wise. So, I'm trying to get this black ring out of my plastic rings. Anything else that you guys would like to do? Whoa. Chat, talk. Joe does bring up the fact that you have a little glowing light on your forehead. I don't know if you're trying to cover
yeah.
that up.
Just a little bit of concealer right there needed.
As you kind of like try and cover it up with like makeup, it's like.
I need to.
No, the concealer won't help that. It does its own thing. This right here is magic.
It's old magic.
I need to go shopping.
You need to go shopping? Okay.
Yes, because I lost my rope due to the monkeys. Remember? They cut it.
So you're trying to go to the crab shack?
Yeah, I need to go get a new rope, and I need
some... Top of the morning to you, laddie!
Let's see if I can find some exotic cooking materials.
This is him. Little groggy. Little...
Hi, how's it going? I need some rope.
It's Finster. Nice to meet you again there. Need rope, you say? How much you need there?
Well, you know, I still got this 30-foot section, but you know, I really like a whole 50-foot roll. Handy to have.
50 feet, huh?
Yeah.
Well then, let me see. I know I got a rope. Let me see. What the fuck is the goddamn price tag on rope?
I gotta look that up.
Here, I got D&D on. Give me 2 seconds and just.
I'm pretty sure it's somewhere like a silver or something. I'll
send Drunk the number. Hempen rope, one gold.
It's one gold. Okay.
You would have okay. Gotten. Then I pull out this cookbook that the good doctor gave me. Do you have any of these ingredients?
What? What was that? Say that again.
Do you have any of these ingredients? They're kind of a little exotic.
Let me open up. I am currently trying to zoom in to this thing.
It the one in Discord doesn't, it's not big enough.
Okay, so...
If you click it and click open original, then you can open it and...
Obelisk, beholder, boiled devil tongue, chicken, Cthulhu claw, dragon turtle soup...
Cthulhu claw?
A cool thought clue. Claw. Sorry.
Okay, I was very concerned about what we were going to try and get for food.
Oh god.
Purple worm cutlets, red dragon tenderloins, rosemary Hendrix bisque, scorpion crescent tablet.
Says, well, I'm not a big purveyor of meats and such, more the basic goods, if I'm being honest. Looking over this sheet of things, you might be able to find some of these things in the forest. Purple worm, you'd probably want to go more up north, towards the mountains and the eastern side. I hear there's a new pot of them going about, tearing up the land. Let me look at, looks more at this,
Oh, they actually have like Hero's Feast on here. That's cool. Magic glazed maple drink.
That sounds like a Christmas monster, like the peppermint dragon.
Spicy root wing?
What does that say on the bottom there? I'm trying to freaking see here. I'm trying to think if he has like anything on this, but I can barely read it. Let's see if I can. God, I wish I could zoom into this a little bit. Sorry, everybody. I'm trying to currently open
it. Oh, it's much better on mobile.
Oh, is it?
It really God damn is. It.
Which one are you talking about? Yeti Tart?
Yeti
Tartar. Ward it's one of the R's. Snake with or Ward Steak.
Spicy something. Spicy root
Spicy wing. Troll ribs. Just below troll spicy ribs. Rock it, wings.
Rock wings. Ah, rock is a devil.
No, rocks demon. Aren't devils, they're giant birds.
They're ROC. Classified in the fiends.
Are they fiends?
Yeah.
Shit, I never thought of them as fiends.
You didn't fucking know that?
Well, the like actual world lore behind rocks, I would put them more as celestials than fiends. Or jinn.
They're like fallen. A lot of succubus and shit like that, they were celestials.
Yeah.
And then they fell. Because they came into the world and then became corrupted. So, most things from heaven that come into the new world can be corrupted pretty easily. getting on a tangent about lore there.
There's a Tarrasque meal.
I might have a bit of prune for you.
I'll take it.
Let me do a little bit of investigation. I'm going to roll for him to actually do an investigation check, see if he has anything.
That's your mission, Drunk. You want to kill a Tarrasque and cook it.
Hell shit!
Yep.
He found it! Here's that was the a natural 20!
Yay!
The Tarrasque meal? Increase all of your physical abilities by 1 point.
Yeah.
Which means all your stats go up one.
That's brilliant. I love it.
God, I want to fucking read these things. Okay, so...
Spicy troll ribs, 100 gold pieces, heal 2 points...
each round.
Each round.
Okay. So basically you can make like a large meal with it if you have 200 gold worth of troll meat.
I'm going to take the 6-piece troll ribs, please.
Yeah. So, it's 200 gold, right? So he's going to offer you...
It's 100 gold.
Oh, 100 gold. So he's going to offer it to you for 100 gold.
Maybe. It looks like it could be 500 gold.
Check that. Fucking check
it. Give me a second to get back to it. I just closed out of it.
Damn it. Everybody's looking at their screens.
I'm looking at my phone.
It is so much easier.
It's 500.
500 gold.
Well, I'll have to come back later.
It's also got a DC to cook it of 17.
Yep. Yeah. I'd say
stay towards the top of the list, you know? Elven whey bread, maybe?
I'm not worried about it. Feeds you for a month. It.
Dwarven hardtack and elven whey bread are essentially food for a week or food for a month.
Alright, well, that's all I need to do for now.
Aboleth calamari.
Tubsy says that we need to hydrate.
I have been.
Okay. I'll hydrate here in a second. I don't have my water bottle in here with me.
Hydro check.
Yes. Hydro. You gain the things that you need to. You got the rope, 1 gold for 50.
I'm continuing on with the Merish. Doesn't know the value of money. He gave him 3 gold.
Okay. The gentleman says that's gracious of you, child, but I ain't no crook, and he hands you back 2 gold.
Okay.
This man's like, he's old, brushy, he's got like this puffy beard, like how I described him before. Almost you barely not see his eyes or his mouth, and he just like has this aura of like, piss off, but
I just ultimately, like
not from your older interaction, he actually likes you quite a bit, so.
I like the whole innocent, not knowing a whole lot, sheltered life, child that I am, so I'm continuing with that.
I like it too. It's a good choice. It's a good.
There's no money in the swamp. Anybody that had it got eaten.
The money got eaten too.
Well, no. Merish is a lizard folk. You know what lizard folk do with their dead?
Yep, they eat them.
You're not allowed to eat the party members.
It's
kind of frog legs. They got quite a kick.
It's an opportunity for food. I'm gonna eat it.
Yep.
Marish right, takes another D4 of psychic damage.
Anything else you guys want to do?
Confirm we're allowed to actually leave this time.
Yeah, you're totally able to leave.
Like, guard is gonna go to Neville. We are leaving soon. I am wanting to make sure this is allowed.
Cool. Bye, Trevor.
He like bashed through, literally like, there's a guard-shaped hole in his door as he just walked in past the guards.
Fucking shit, man!
We are leaving town. No arresting this time.
You pay for the hole in the fucking wall, and yeah!
He just like walks back and takes all the parts that stuck to him and puts them back in the wall.
That's not how that works!
He's an anime character, of course it is. he would give him a couple of gold. He'd give him a couple of gold to pay for the wall. I cast
prestidigitation, so it looks like it's been fixed.
Prestidigitation can't do that. Yeah, but no,
he'll cast minor illusion to make sure.
he'll just put 3 gold down on Neville's desk and leave.
Neville just goes like, "Get the fuck out of my town."
Bye, Neville.
I'll set up my caravan.
He's not a murder hobo. He's just an ignorant robot.
So I am going to add something for a second. As you guys begin to leave, you do notice something on, and I'll have to add it later. Yip is holding a katana to his side.
Oh.
I'm assuming for size-wise, it's more like a wakizashi?
Yeah.
No, Yip's got a 6-foot bladed odachi. Just like, ooh, new toy for
his size. It is straight up like a small katana, like rope and thing. It looks as though it was like kind of designed towards their thing, and yeah, just has it. I'll add it to their thing here in a little bit, but yeah.
I'm gonna go head down, grab my caravan and wheel it up to them.
Okay. The one guard that was put in charge of it, they've actually like put a little bit of like a watch on it because nobody told him to leave. So he's just like, "Hey, you fucking take this." So yeah. He's just like, "Oh, sir, thank you."
I'm just gonna tip my hat and just get up in the front seat and just sort of like.
I wish we were there.
Just go and whistle to the oxen and just...
Con save really quick.
Con save? Oh, shit. Just
make a con save.
That's a 10?
You fart a little bit in the guy's face. As you get up, he's like, oh, fuck, man! What the hell?
Sorry, I ate swordfish last night. You know what that does to you? Oof.
No, I don't!
Well, then again, a lizard folk did cook it, so...
It was quite good. Had some cranberries on it.
I had no idea what you put in it.
It was a little spicy.
Why is it spicy?
Spicy.
I kind of wish that you had tipped your hat around guard, because then he could just tip his head. Just
nearly headless Nick.
Nah, his head doesn't come off. Not without some screws being undone.
Wait, theoretically, if he undid the screws and then took his head off, would that not count as damage? Because I know
Would.
That kind
of disassembly, it's taken his head off.
I always thought with Warforge, like, if it was meant to come apart for maintenance, like,
I
that
feel
would not
like,
count as damage.
I feel like his self is focused in the gems and in his, like, band on his head, so the head would still be alive, but his body would be dead.
That's what I mean, like, the parts that are connected to his consciousness would still be working, but his body would then just collapse into a heap of broken armor.
Just...
That's kind of neat.
He just tips his faceplate up.
How do I make a non-magical item in D&D Beyond?
Let me see.
Oh, add a custom item.
Yeah, you have to do custom item in character sheets. Otherwise, just if you add a longsword, you can customize the item, and then you're just using the same stats.
I can do edit. Okay. So I can do this.
Yeah. For anybody that didn't know that, if you have something like a greatsword and you go in, there's a customize button. That's how one of my characters has a, I can't remember what the hell it is. I renamed
cost is
their longsword, so it was actually katana.
3 gold. Note.
Yeah.
Need five. Missed. Wait, I spelled that wrong. I've spelled my freaking NPC's name wrong. Guys.
Wait, is this... is this Mama Owen's sword?
No. It is okay. A different one.
This is when we find out Yip's parents were, like, famous adventurers. Oh. Six. I love... okay, I have a backstory I need to use now.
Okay. Your parents were famous adventurers, and you're trying to live up to that expectation.
Mama Owens, the brothel owner who has raised Yip... used to be an adventurer, right, Dono?
I might have to remove that. I need to add a weapon, but whatever. I'll figure out how to do that after stream.
Yeah, I can walk you through it after stream.
Yeah.
But like, imagine,
yeah, she used,
like,
to be an adventurer.
Your adventure party, two of them have a kid, and then they die, so you adopt their kid. Like, I just love that kind of story.
Yeah, you guys actually don't know very much about Yip besides that.
No, because
you can't talk.
Yeah, Yip is nonverbal.
Yep.
Well,
nonverbal character.
Partially nonverbal.
All right. You guys begin your adventure. What is the name of your oxen? I'm just curious. Put it on the spot there, huh?
Spock and Kirk.
Spock and Kirk?
I thought you were going to go for Jerry and Kramer.
Make an animal handling check to just get them to go.
They know me though. They've been like years.
You can make it with advantage.
Yeah, guard 7's just walking beside the oxen. I'm assuming we've put like Merish and Yip inside the cart.
Merish,
that's a 16.
Yeah, I guess I'm gone. So you guys begin to make your travel into the road and leave Paris behind. We are now finally leaving the first town.
Again. With permission this time.
You guys went from the lake of the first town to...
I mean, we traveled like 3 days away. That's a good distance.
Yeah, that's true. All right. In your travels, is there anything that you guys want to talk about? Communicate? It's a little bit of travel. Let me get my book out.
It's about 5 till, so I don't know.
Yeah, you guys can talk about something for a little bit. If you want, I can just skip the traveling, and we can roll to see if you guys encounter anything.
God, where are you from? You just kind of showed up out of nowhere.
Hope everybody's enjoying my booty.
I do not remember exactly where it is, but I was made in Temple of Nayla, goddess...
What did I actually make her the goddess of?
How can you not remember? I remember my swamp. I vaguely know how to get back there.
He essentially explains how, like, there's damage to parts of him. Because he was sent out on, like, a mission. Like, he told you guys he knows he has a mission. But he doesn't remember what it is because of whatever has damaged him. And he can't repair that part of himself. But yeah, he's from the Temple of Nayla, the goddess of artifice.
And anybody that wants to, you can make a history check or religion check.
Well, I'll do that.
Yeah, that's
very obscure minor goddess.
11.
11? You don't really know much about Nayla. That doesn't sound like a real god.
Yeah, I didn't. I only got a 3.
Okay.
Yeah. I the way I think me and Dono had figured it, like, you would probably need a 20. Because very obscure. But yeah, they make constructs and warforged and such. And he essentially, I'll say as we're traveling, he's like explaining how they told him that the warforged are made with the spirits or souls of like warriors of Nayla. So like he may have been a person at some point in the past, but he doesn't know and doesn't remember.
That's weird. We've got a weird group.
Alright,
there always is weird groups I come across them all the time.
High or low?
Who?
Anybody.
Hi.
Oh, I was gonna defer to the guest.
Okay.
I'm getting an encounter.
Oh no.
Griffins and creepy woods ladies again.
Would you like to roll the percentile, or would you like me to roll the percentile?
Pete can roll the percentile.
Okay.
He's over there. Next to me.
Oh shit. Oh shit.
Opposite corner on my screen, drunk. He's that way from me, and 18? I'm above you.
18.
You're that way to me.
And like, Donna's down here, shop's over there. And
you guys can switch. You guys know that you can switch, like, where everybody is, right?
I like where everybody is.
Move them.
Oh, hey, you can.
Yeah, I'm top right corner. Pete's next to me. Dono's bottom left.
Sorry, everybody. This is our first time using Zoom.
To our podcast listeners, catch the YouTube or watch us on Twitch to see the weird shit we're talking about.
Hello, Leo.
So you're now directly above me.
Yep. And then Pete's there. Dono's there.
Dono.
Yeah. Oh.
Shop, you're still here, and Drunk, you're still there. You're there, and
there. I have it set to what Shop has it.
So. Yeah.
All right. You guys begin to have, like, you guys travel for a couple, or quite a while. You make camp. So whoever wants to make watch can do that. Whoever would like to do watch. You can.
I will try and position myself for my 6 hours where I have to be inactive. So I'll take last watch. I'll take the last watch and then try and position myself so I have the widest view. Mm-hmm. From my inactive state.
Okay.
Perception?
Yep. Perception checks.
That is a 13.
13? Okay. It is a beautiful night. You can see the two moons. They seem to be slightly... They're not full, but they seem to be slightly filling in both ways. It's very strange. You've actually never seen, not looking at the moons, both of them being almost full like that. There's either one that's almost completely closed off, or one that's almost new, and the other one's coming into full, or the other way around.
The moons don't look this pretty back in the swamp.
Yeah, because you would usually have, like, the trees in the way.
Yep. That's what I was going for, too. Mm-hmm. Glad you got that.
Yep. But, like, you just kind of hear the creaking and chirping of birds. It's getting to that colder weather now. You can feel, like, a slight chill within the air. You kind of pull your blanket a little bit closer to you as you begin watching the fire burns a little brighter, and you just kind of look off and enjoy. It's a little creepy, but peaceful in the same.
I'm red with excitement.
Okay. Your watch comes to a close without any problems.
Okay. Hey, weird guy, you're up.
I roll out of my now of my trailer and just jump, like, flop on the floor.
Goes on. All right. What am I doing?
You got this watch. I'm going to bed.
2 hours.
2 hours? Oh my god, I'm going.
And the whole time, leaned up against a tree, just staring, his eyes, like, are just plain crystal. It's just,
and don't you know, Shop, like, when you're in your, like, passive state, you can make a...
Disadvantage check, I know.
Yeah, it's a disadvantage check.
I don't have dark vision, so it's a disadvantage anyways.
I know.
I look over at God and just...
So the way he's sitting, essentially, like, his feet are... Oh, there's actually a term for it. It's the way that you would kneel, like a formal kneeling position in Japanese culture, where like your feet are underneath you and your hands are on your knees.
I'm trying to remember the name because we used to do it for.
Come on, we're all weebs. One of us has to know this.
Well, I used to freaking train judo, so we ended up having to do that before we kneeled out.
Used to do karate. We used to have to do that all the time. The thing is, I was like 8 when I did it, so I can't remember.
I can't remember. It's been a couple years since I've trained.
Seiza style.
Yeah.
Yeah, so he's sitting Seiza style with his hands just sitting on his lap. Like, like the statues of Buddha.
Yeah.
All right. Make a perception check for me.
Like, first of all, I'm like caught up with looking at a guard, just, that's creepy.
Disadvantage 16 for guard.
Oh no, that's a 5.
The 5? All right. You don't notice anything. You're actually kind of like constantly rubbing your eyes because it just keeps going fuzzy and you're just like sagging. Like, oh, you're just like, fuck, why am I here? You're asleep in my tent, my wagon the entire time. Every time you've ever traveled, you just sleep in the wagon with it locked.
Yeah.
And
just trust nothing comes near my oxen.
Yeah, exactly. Like, nobody's gonna fuck with giant fucking oxen. Nobody cares. You make a constitution save for me, just because you did make the comment of being, like, so tired. So I'm just gonna see if your character passes out.
7.
Okay. Yeah. Fuck. You do fall asleep. Just you're just like...
So it's just sort of like flop down in front of the wheel of his cart, just.
Song logs.
And that means nobody wakes up for the next part, so. Guard, shit. Make perception with disadvantage. So you're the only one able to do it.
Huh? Ah. I can try not to roll out of the thing. So it's a disadvantage, which means it's an 18, because I rolled a 14 and the other side was a natural 20.
Oh.
So 18 total.
18, okay. Right. You, in your passive unconscious state, with the fire slowly dying because nobody's there to kind of keep watch, see what seems to be... You hear the sound of, like, birds chirping out into the distance. And you see just, like, this big, long, lengthy arm come out from the tree that looks like a branch itself. And you just hear...
He's...
This thing's massive.
Yeah, he activates and his sword is out as soon as he's active.
It disappears as soon as that happens.
Okay, he's gonna, like, shake Babylon awake. You should go back to sleep and wake up Briar. Because how long into that third watch was that?
Probably about an hour.
Okay, so there's still 3 hours left.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so he put Babylon back in, wake up Briar, and have Briar sit for her last hour of her watch, and then he's gonna go and finish his inactive state.
Okay.
To avoid exhaustion.
So I will roll for Briar. I do not believe that she has proficiency in perception.
Got a plus +1.
Yeah.
And advantage.
There's a reason I took proficiency in perception.
I don't know why, but it says she's got advantage.
Probably.
Oh, she has her shifter ability. She'd have advantage on perception checks based on it should say under racial. It'll be either sight or sound.
Wisdom perception checks lets you spot, hear, and not otherwise detect that presence of something. It measures the general awareness of your surroundings and the keenness of your senses. Now, for example, you might try to hear conversation through a closed door.
No. You want to go to her features and
on
traits.
On checks that rely on hearing or smell. Heightened senses.
Yep.
Okay.
There it is.
So with that... new knowledge, you will actually see as you go to get her, she's awake.
I was bearable and fell asleep. I was aware there was three arm. Be careful. I go back. And he goes back to his tree.
And she's kind of like... You can see that she's like partially shifted. Like her fang is slightly grown out a little bit. And she's just kind of calming down.
Okay.
So... Alright, she will make her perception check with advantage. Oh, shit. she got an 8. I rolled a 4 and a 7.
Would you like me to roll again?
Sure. You can do it every single time.
I know, I just, since it was only still in the middle of the watch, I didn't know if my existing perception check carried over. Mm.
16 and 7 total.
7?
Okay. Yeah, 16 total.
So basically the same amount. You guys just passively go through the night and the sun rises. So.
Yeah, and then guard takes over for his last 2 hours and lets her get a couple more hours of shut-eye.
Alright, Merish, what are you sleeping?
What do I sleep in?
Yeah, what are you sleeping? Do you sleep in like a sleeping bag?
No, I just curl up under a blanket.
Okay. As you wake up in the blanket, you begin to suffocate as you're... And you find yourself completely restrained by constrictor snakes.
Oh, no.
I need you to make a constitution save to even be able to breathe at this moment. As you...
Natural 20.
Okay. Yay. You were able to get a gust of air into your lungs. What would you like to do?
Give me a second.
Do I have any constrictor snakes?
That would hurt me too. I'm gonna yell out for help.
Okay.
Help! Guys, it's got me!
The snake saw the lizard and is hungry.
you guys see Merish like literally trying to wiggle and get out of a blanket?
Eldritch Blast.
Oh, fuck! Actually, no, Eldritch Blast is specifically targeted. It doesn't have splash damage.
But he also cannot see the snakes because they're underneath the blanket.
Oh, it's underneath the blanket.
Okay. I thought that like the blanket was getting kicked aside and we'd see it.
I thought that the snake just...
Can't,
I thought the snake just, can, like, just went
barely
around
see
him.
The snakes, and he's completely constricted underneath of his blanket.
Oh, I see. I thought it was like a huge constrictor snake just going around him and the blanket.
You don't know how many there are, but there's a few that you can feel like tightening in yourself. Yeah, that's what I thought.
Guard is gonna run over and just see what the hell Merish is screaming about, I guess.
You see Merish, like his face is turning purple, but like not his entire skin color. You pull it open and there are three constrictor snakes that one has his feet, one has his chest, and the arms, and the other one has around his neck, and he's beginning to choke.
I would like to use, if it would work, I want to use athletics to try and pull, like, put one hand on the snake that's on his chest as leverage, and yank the one around his throat off.
It's gonna be straight strength checks.
Okay, straight strength. Either way, yeah. Just no proficiency bonus then.
And it will be contested by the snakes themselves, so...
Let's see who has a higher strength, me or the snakes. 19.
You definitely are able to get one, and you just kind of tear at it, and it's like, and you're putting pressure on Merish because you're using him on top of like...
Yeah, I'm trying to press on the snake, but knowing that I'm pressing on Merish.
Yeah,
and get Merish it free.
Make a con save as you're getting like this 300-pound freaking
machine pushing into your chest.
He doesn't weigh that much.
14.
He
14?
Weighs 298 pounds.
You're able to continue your breathing? No, it's becoming harder and harder at this moment.
Yeah, once the neck one's off, toss that, and then literally I want to rip the one on his chest in half.
I cast Hellish Rebuke on the first one that gets torn off.
So, Hellish Rebuke against which one?
Yeah.
The one that I pulled off, I tossed it.
Okay.
Like, as it's flying through the air, I cast Hellish Rebuke.
Okay, real quick, 18, does that hit you, Drunk?
18?
Yeah.
Yes, it does, because I can't cast Mage Armor.
And you don't have shield.
You take 5 plus, I believe it's 2. Yeah, 5 plus 2. 7 points of piercing damage. Or bludgeoning damage. No, piercing damage. Yeah, piercing damage. I need to be making those. Okay. That one will get you. You will be... And you take another 7 points of bludgeoning damage as you are being constricted and pulled together with the other snake.
I may survive one more round.
Yeah.
Can I...
Ooh.
The
other
snake...
one from Hellish Rebuke just blows.
Yeah, the snake around his chest, can I literally try and rip it in half?
Yes. Make a... What would that be?
Would
Make
it be
an attack?
That's what I was wondering.
And then use your like
unarmed
strength.
Attack or strength.
Yeah, unarmed attack. Yeah, it would be unarmed. So
yeah, so just essentially roll an unarmed strike.
Anything like that.
Roll an unarmed strike, and then we'll figure out damage. Because I have a flat 5 for unarmed damage. Fuck, 1. Natural fucking 1.
It is really slippery and it's so tightly coiled within there.
Time to make an adult character drunk.
Well, he still has death saves, but you know.
And we have Briar and Yip to help us.
Oh yeah, that's right. Briar wakes up and begins clawing at it.
Yeah, please.
She's gonna hit.
Wait, also.
And then with her offhand attack.
Should we initiative this?
I'm just kind of playing this as it goes.
Okay.
You really want to roll initiative and spend like 5 minutes freaking figuring that out. I'm just kind of like, what are your guys' instincts on this? Go. So, I believe
oh, yes. Engage
swords.
Arms. Right.
Plus your dexterity.
No, he's... I don't know if anybody's ever, like, pulled
so prior,
on a really tight part of
as you go to try
rope.
And, like, grab the one, just instead instinctually puts her, like, sharp, like, just her sharp nails just go shink out and just... and stabs into it and tears the snake apart and it stops moving. It has still constricted you, but you can now easily pull it off. Yip is going to use the katana.
I can talk now, right?
Yes, you can totally talk at this point.
Your arms are free too, right? So you have somatic control?
I'm going to yell at the top of my...
Does somebody want to tell me what Yip's dexterity is?
Yeah, give me a sec. I will pull up the character sheet.
I'm gonna yell. You need... Get off me, you ugly, slimy little thing! Go buy some insurance!
Plus 2.
Plus 2? Okay.
And cast Vicious Mockery.
Okay. 2 plus 4. That's gonna hit that. So she takes out the little katana that she was given, or Zambakuto, or whatever it's
Wakizashi.
Called.
Wakizashi.
Wakizashi.
What are we? What is she?
And she's gonna cut into it, and she's actually able to make purchase, and does 4 points of damage because she doesn't have proficiency with the weapon. He doesn't have proficiency. Fuck me, running. Keep freaking fucking up on that. What is the save?
DC 13. Wisdom.
Wisdom. Has a +0 to it. It fails.
It takes 3 points of psychic damage and has disadvantage on its next attack roll.
Okay, it's still alive. It is still on you and now is going to actually make its attack roll. So, disadvantage. 3. That's going to be a fail because I'm pretty sure 7 doesn't hit you.
No, it does not.
Okay. And so
Yeah. That's the end of that snake's turn. Anything else that you'd like to do?
Can I cast command on that snake to tell it to let go?
Sure.
I point my finger at it and just shout, release!
Is it a wisdom save, I'm guessing?
I believe so.
Either way, it's going to fail.
Command is like a page.
Unless there's like a certain level of intelligence that it doesn't work on them.
Oh, sorry, no, the spell has no effect if the target is undead or does not understand your language. So okay. No, I'm not gonna yeah, cast that.
Okay.
Instead, I like to cast Eldritch Blast on the snake's head.
Okay.
You're just like point blank range, bitch.
It's like the finger touching its head. Just so Eldritch Blast.
This is where you find out you took Eldritch Spear.
Oh yeah, 19.
19. That'll hit. And as long as you roll higher than a 4, it should be dead.
10 damage.
Nice. So you just like hit its head. You hit its head and blows off. And then Merish is just wrapped with a snake's cording around it, but his Joe's loose. Steph taught. So
Merish, can you cook snake?
I feel like his mom taught him like snake kebabs in the swamp.
I'm gonna go lay down now.
Laying down got you in this position, though.
You can lay down on my cart.
So good.
Right. That fight's over. When it comes to like small things like that, I don't want you guys to roll initiative because I feel like initiative takes so much time. That's more of just like
as long as we to this situation. We all take turns.
Yeah. And so like I'll just be like, what is your decision? What is your decision? So you guys are just shooting things out and it's just like, oh, my character is freezing at this moment. All right, they're going to attack. And it ups it kind of creates a different type of battle and more of like a challenge for you guys. And so like in low situations like that, where it's just like doesn't really make sense to do an initiative count.
You're good.
But like if you guys are in a big fight and battle is like going to be a huge thing to help you win. But these were like snakes with like 10 health. So it wasn't going to be like a huge thing to fucking kill them. So.
You like my ode to Jerry?
We should probably call it soon. Oh, wait, it's about 20 minutes over.
Are my oxen okay? Because I reckon they'd be an easy
target. Oh, yeah, they're fine. They're fine.
Toby did say in the chat that apparently Guard just went, oh, you said pull, not push.
He pushes the air out of him.
Tries to push two ends of a snake smaller.
So with that, we will continue with our guest next session next week. Pete. And I guess we're done for the day. thank you guys all for watching. Lovely to have you all here. For those that missed the pod or missed the casting, thank you for listening in the recording. But until next week, may the adventure continue. Till then, roll for initiative.